Hello viewers, I am Dr. Jeevan Chandra from Microbiology Department working in Chaitanya D University Warangal. I would like to discuss about the concept of biofertilizers in drought conditions. Today, world is experiencing severe drought as well as the global population has been increasing enormously. Both are interlinking with the population exploitation as well as the resource allocation and food production and sustainable development. Both are heavily interlinked with each other. So the demand and supply ratio are also huge. So by 2030 demand has been increased by 50%. In this condition we have to achieve our crop yield in a sustainable manner. So another most important feature of a global warming, it is going to impose in several abrupt stresses like water deficiency, high temperature and crop and climate changes. These all are interlinked with each other. So when these changes occur throughout the globe, drought is accelerated. So according to survey conducted by International Water Stress Survey, our India also comes under a heavily affected area. It is experiencing more than 80% of water deficiency and climate change factors. Another striking feature is that it is about 54% and high concentration of drought is there. It is interlinked with high and extreme stress is experienced by several states of India. Our Telangana also included in this region. Such a way we require a sustainable approach to break this barrier. In order to cope up with this technology, we must learn the ingredients and essentialities of global warming, what it is going to affect. Global warming is directly affecting melting of glaciers and heavy floods, as well as perturbations of environmental temperature, pH and soil fluctuations. These are all interlinked with each other. So water deficiency going to be increased, sometimes maybe decreased. So either extreme conditions, high water deficiency or high water availability or low water availability, both are going to directly affect the crop yield. At the same time, temperature also, we are also experiencing high temperature and low temperature, cold effect. Both are going to fluctuate the metabolism of the plant system. As well as the radiation, environmental radiation also going to be increased several folds. UV radiation and visible light is also fluctuating. Sometimes cosmic radiation like gamma radiation is also going to increase enormously. These all effects are contributing to global warming. Eventually, that leads to affect the agriculture crop yield and the productivity. The challenge is that we have to achieve the plant productivity in a sustainable manner. At the same time, environmentally sustainable manner, we have to manage the abiotic stress and biotic stress, and environmental safety practices has to be followed and implemented, and at the same time satisfy the human needs of the entire global population. In order to achieve this, we have to implement some sustainable practices. Since last 70 years, we have been using excess amounts of chemical fertilizers, and these chemical fertilizers are going to affect the soil health and productivity. So biofertilizers are the promising agents which are going to improve the crop yield without affecting the soil health as well as the plant health. So use of biofertilizers is one of the most important feature. So we have to understand the biofertilizer concept very effectively. For this purpose, we have to address some of the issues regarding the biofertilizer. What is biofertilizer? Biofertilizer is a composition made by live microbial cells which is using as the organic input or agriculture input. So finally, the biofertilizer going to promote the crop yield and plant health as well as the environmental friendly approach. Coming to the biofertilizers. There are so many biofertilizers are listed here. Some of them are bacteria, some of them are fungi, some of them are actomycetes, some of them are cyanobacteria, some of them are some of the biofertilizers that are exerting bactericidal effect. So, as like the bactericidal effect means they are going to kill the pathogenic microorganisms. Such a way they are called bactericidal agents. For example, Agrobacterium, as well as the Bacillus polybixa, Bacillus pericus, Bacillus subtilis, and Pseudomonas aeruginosa. These are used for maintaining several diseases like a crown gall disease and Bacillus polybixa. These are the agents which could be used as biofertilizers. Pseudomonas is very important microorganism. This Pseudomonas going to act as a control of several diseases. Coming to the fungicidal agents, fungicidal activity, some of the microorganisms also exhibit fungal toxicity. Such a way, these microorganisms going to control the fungal diseases. Such a way, these agents are acting as a fungicidal agents. In this fungicidal activity, several bacillus species and Pseudomonas, Trichoderma and Burkholderia and some other Citrobacter, these are the species which could able to better mold the fungicidal activity. In addition to fungicidal activity, some of the agents also possessing insecticidal activity. So insects can be controlled. Such a way, we are using enormous number of microorganisms as agents to control insects rather than the chemical agents. For example, Bacillus thuringiensis, which is going to control the butterflies as well as the other Lepidoptera species. And Beveria messalia, which is also applied as a foliar spray. And Metarhizium aerosomine and Verticillium leccani, as well as the other species of some viruses also used as the insecticidal agents. Coming to herbicidal agents, so in agricultural land we are also experiencing so many weeds and herbs also there, dicotyledon and monocotyledon plants. These can be effectively controlled by using herbicidal microorganisms. Generally, herbicidal microorganisms, Xanthomonas, Tamestris and Alternaria, Destructum, Polytotrichum and as well as the Chondrosporium, Phytophthora, as well as the Puccinia. These are the, some of the species can be used as fungicidal controlling agents that will be able to control the herbicides. Next, nematicidal. Nematodes can be controlled by several group of organisms like Bacillus, Firmus and Verticillium and Myrotecium. These are the species can be used as the nematicidal agents. Coming to the mode of action, how biofertilizers will work? Biofertilizers will work by two phenomena. First one is enhancement of plant nutrient uptake. The second one, improving the soil quality. Soil quality can be improved several ways. So both situations are very important. Such a way, biofertilizers either molding the effective nutrient enhancement or improving the soil fertility, both are eventually leads to crop yield maximization. So these are going to increase the crop yield by several phenomena. Rhizobium bacteria and other organisms, Pseudomonas and Burkholderia, they are well versed in nitrogen fixation. And at the same time, some of the organisms are going to mobilize the phosphate and potassium, zinc and heavy metal. So they are also contributing to phosphate solubilization as well as the phosphate mobilization and potassium mobilization. Some of them are also going to excrete the phytohormones like indolecithic acid, gibberellic acid and other phytohormones. They are directly promoting the plant growth. And production of antimicrobial components like antibiotics, they are going to kill the organisms. Previously we have discussed. some of the organisms are secreting the epicellular activity, some of them are bactericidal, some of them are nematicidal, some of them are viricidal. Like that, a wide variety of organisms are available in the nature. They can be act as the effective biofertilizer treatment. Today we covered the concept of biofertilizers. In upcoming videos, other aspects will be discussed. Thank you for now.